Okay, so we're going to go forward with our Shape Layer accent library. So in this episode, we're going to be making a burst. You may have made bursts before. You may have seen other tutorials. The way I'm going to do it, you'll only have to make this one Shape Layer burst, and you'll never have to make another one again. You can bring this in with the click of a button, and all of your options will be right there on your layer. Command or Control R to bring up our rulers, and we just want to bring in a horizontal ruler, right-click, and let's put that at 540. Bring in a vertical ruler and right click, let's make that 960. The reason why is because this comp is 1920 by 1080 and the math for doing a burst is actually very, very important, especially the way that we'll be making it today. Right click in this area, this is to the left of your timeline. We're gonna go new, shape layer, open that up. We wanna add in a group and let's just call this burst. And actually let's call the shape layer burst because like Ben Marriott says, we always label our layers. Let's add in a path, which will prompt your pen tool. And we're just going to make a line. This should snap right to your guide here. If it doesn't, go to view. You want to snap to guides. I'm going to add in a stroke. Open up those stroke settings. Let's make our stroke width 20. Change this butt cap to a round cap. Click on our path. We want to make sure that this one vertex is right here in the center. Add in a trim paths. So open up that trim paths and put keyframes on start and end and make those both 0%. Shift page down twice to go forward 20 frames, make those both 100. Now we can select all of these keyframes, F9 to make those easy ease. Select the second keyframe on our end percentage, go to our graph editor and pull the handle over. Let's loop this area and just watch it play back. Add in a repeater. So open up the repeater settings, set our position 0, 0. So now for our number of copies, it defaults to 3. I'm going to make this 10 for now. Option alt click onto rotation and type 360 divided by. So it's our 360 divided by because 360 degrees is how many degrees are in a circle and pick whip up to our copies. So now this will keep everything in a circular pattern. Since we have that expression on there, I can change the number of copies. Say like if I wanted 12, it'll update to 12, but it will keep the circular pattern. We can make 8 and still it stays in that circular pattern. Let's go ahead and hide our guides. Go up to view, click on show guides. Select this layer, go over to our effects and presets. First, let's add in a color control. Double click that, open up stroke settings, pick whip our color over to the color of this color control. So now whatever we set this to, our burst will automatically conform to that. Type in slider control, name this one stroke width, duplicate that, and name this one copies. Here's our stroke width. Right now it's set to 20, so let's go ahead and make our stroke width over here 20, and we're going to pick whip over to that expression control. Changes to say 15, you'll see that our stroke decreases in size. So whatever you set this stroke width to, it will update automatically on your layer. Close up our stroke, open up our repeater. Number of copies right here is now 10. Make that 10. And since we have this expression, whatever we change the number of copies to, it will update automatically. So let's make this 15. Make this 5. Go over to our effects and presets. Type in point control. And this is basically going to control the position of where this burst is because you may want to be in a different location in your comp. P for position. Pick whip this point control right here. You can now move this around. Add in another slider control. Name this one scale. S for scale and pick whip that. We have it set to 0, so we're going to see it disappear. If we bring this back up to 100, now it's back up to 100. So say if you wanted it to be smaller, 50, whatever you change this to, it's going to update. And the last one I want to add in is an angle control. And this is going to be our rotation. So if for any reason you want your rotation to be different on this, just change that. Now see, we can move it around and we can see it can rotate. And all of these are keyframeable too. These all have stopwatches. Anytime you see a stopwatch, it means you can keyframe it. Open this back up and we want to select our contents, effects, and transform properties. Go to animation, save animation preset. And this is going to bring you to your documents, Adobe. I'm in 2023 user presets and I have a folder for 7-Minute AE and I created this folder last time for Shape Layer Accent Library. So I'm going to call this Burst. Click Save. Get rid of that. Go back over to our effects and presets and we open up our animation presets, user presets. We have our Shape Layer Accent Library and we see right here we have Burst. Whenever you add in an animation preset, it's going to drop your first keyframe wherever your playhead is. For example, if I have my playhead at the 1 second mark and I double click on burst, hit U, you'll see that the first keyframe is here. So I always like to bring it in exactly where I want the shape layer to be dropped in. We have the burst that we created, and we also have our keyframes, and then we have all of these expression controls that we added in. Duplicate this layer and you can offset it. This has its own controls now, so you can change the color of it. Maybe you want to have 15 points and maybe you want to make it thinner. Maybe you want to make it smaller. So if we watch that playback, we see now that we have two bursts. By creating the burst in this way, you can now bring it back in with the click of a button. So I encourage you to come back next time to see what shape layer accent we create next and expand our shape layer accent library. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free, and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors, and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.